फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू सीतुस बायोलॉजी टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई ऑलरेडी गेव द बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट व्हाट इज मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल व्हाट आर द पार्ट्स इन्वॉल्वड इन द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल एंड व्हाट आर द हार्मोन्स आर प्लेइंग ए मेजर रोल ड्यूरिंग द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल एंड व्हाट आर द फेसेस आर इन्वॉल्वड इन द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू know about the ovarian cycle. In the previous video, I already said that the menstrual cycle run in the form of the two cycles. That is the uterine cycle and next one is the ovarian cycle. The uterine cycle main role is the change of the changes which occur in the uterus is known as the uterine cycle and the changes which occur in the ovary is known as the ovarian cycle. Based on these two cycles only, the menstrual cycle is going to run. Today in this video, we are going to know about in brief about the ovarian cycle. Let's see what is that. In the previous video, I already said that the brain is also playing a major role during the menstrual cycle. For what sake, what is the main role played by this brain is for regulation of the hormones. In the brain part, the hypothalamus is the part which is going to produce the gonadotropin releasing hormones. These gonadotropin releasing hormones which are released from the hypothalamus is going to produce the FSH and LH from the anterior pituitary gland. These all are going to regulate the hormones in our body. From the release of hormones from the hypothalamus only, our ovarian cycle is going to start. Let's see. This is the hypothalamus which is mainly present in the beneath the brain. That is, this hypothalamus is going to produce the gonadotropin releasing hormones. GnRH is nothing but the gonadotropin releasing hormones. Under the hypothalamus, the pituitary glands are present. One portion is designated as the anterior pituitary and one portion is designated as the posterior pituitary based on their position. When the gonadotropin releasing hormones are going to be liberated from the hypothalamus, these gonadotropin releasing hormones are going to activate the anterior pituitary gland for liberating the two hormones that are known as the follicle stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone. Understood, na? This gonadotropin is going to activate the anterior pituitary gland. After the activation of the anterior pituitary gland, this anterior pituitary gland is going to liberate follicle stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone. Here I want to say that what are the main functions are going to play by these two hormones. These follicle stimulating hormones, in the name itself it is known that follicle stimulating, it is going to play a major role as a to stimulate or to develop the follicles in the ovary. This cycle is majorly running on the ovary only, na? So these are going to stimulate or going to develop the follicles in the ovary. And this luteinizing hormone is going to play a major role or going to produce or going to cause the ovulation in the ovary. These are the main roles played by these two hormones. This is the ovary part. Now we are going to see the transection of the ovary and what are the cells or what are the follicles which are mainly present in the ovary. Let's see. This is the transverse section of the ovary which is present in the female reproductive system. This ovary contains the 200,000 number of immature primary follicles in this. Means about 200,000 of immature primary follicles are going to present in each ovary of the female reproductive system. Let's see what are the changes are going to occur in this ovary. These are the different changes which are going to occur in the ovary. The changes which are going to occur in the ovary is known as the ovarian cycle. What was the class today? Now, Let's see what are the changes are going to occur in the ovary. I already said that in the previous that the each ovary contains about 2 lakh number of the immature primary follicles in it. These are the immature primary follicles. I already said that this ovarian cycle is going to run or start with the release of hormones from the hypothalamus. Means the hypothalamus is going to release the gonadotropin hormone, releasing hormones. That gonadotropin releasing hormone is going to activate or stimulate the anterior pituitary. That anterior pituitary is going to release the FSH and also the LH. In these immature primary follicles, the follicle stimulating hormones which are going to be released by the anterior pituitary is going to act on the immature primary follicles. Means this FSH is act on these immature primary follicles. After the action of this FSH on the immature primary follicles, these are going to convert into the from the immature to the mature primary follicles. This immature primary follicle is the first stage. Means what are the changes occurring in the ovarian cycle? I designated it as a numbers. The first one, immature primary follicle, is going to convert into the, means the first change, which is going to convert into the mature primary follicle by the action of FSH, that is known as the follicle stimulating hormone, which is released by the anterior pituitary gland. After, when the mature primary follicle is going to be formed, this mature primary follicle is going to be converted into the secondary follicle, which is going to develop into the from the primary to the secondary follicle. This is the third change which is mainly occurring in the ovarian cycle. And the next one, when the secondary follicle is formed, then the graafian follicle, the secondary follicle is going to develop into the graafian follicle, which is the fourth change. When the graafian follicles are formed in the ovary, then these graafian follicles are going to produce the estrogen hormone in the ovary. When this estrogen hormone is produced, this estrogen is going to help the endometrium, which is present at the linings of the uterus. This estrogen is going to help the endometrium to regenerate, to reform the endometrium in the linings of the uterus. This is the endometrium which is present at the walls of the uterus. This endometrium is going to be regenerated by the release of estrogen hormone from the graafian follicle which is developed in the ovary. This estrogen liberates from the graafian follicle. Later, the follicles get ruptured. The follicle gets ruptured and the ovum inside the follicle is released out of the ovary. This is the rupture of the follicle, and inside the ovum which is going to, or the egg which is present inside the follicle, is going to be released outside the ovary. When this process is known as the ovulation. When it is going to happen means when the estrogen is liberated, later the increase in the luteinizing hormone may occur. I already said that in the starting that the anterior pituitary is going to liberate the FSH and also the LH. FSH is playing a major role to develop the follicles in the ovary, and LH is going to play a major role in the ovulation. FHS played a major role for developing the primary, secondary graafian follicles. After the graafian follicle, when it releases the estrogen, later the luteinizing hormone is going to increase. When the luteinizing hormone is increased, then it starts its function, that it going to form or stimulate the ovulation, that is nothing but the release of ovum from the follicle. This is the fifth step which is mainly occurred in the ovary. This ovulation is mainly occurred in the 14th day of the menstrual cycle. I already said that in the previous video that ovarian cycle is run in the two phases, that is the follicular phase. The next one is the luteal phase. luteal phase. In the name itself, now we came to know that the development of the follicles in the ovary is known as the follicular phase, which is going to occur in the ovarian cycle. Let's see what is the luteal phase, which is going to occur in the ovarian. After the ovulation process, the corpus luteum, which is in the immature form, is going to be matured, which is nothing but the yellow body. Corpus luteum is also known as the yellow body. This mature corpus luteum is going to secrete the progesterone hormone. This progesterone hormone is going to help or makes the endometrium, endomatous and the secretory. Means it is going to help the endometrium to make a stiffness and going to secrete some of the substances which is going to be secretory. It means this progesterone is going to make the endometrium more functionally. This is the main role played by the corpus luteum in the menstrual cycle. This is the sixth change which is occurred in the ovarian cycle. When the mature corpus luteum done its function, later the mature corpus luteum is developed or into the corpus albicans. When this mature corpus luteum is developed into the corpus luteum, means when the ovum is released into the uterus from the ovarian, from the ovary, the ovum is released, right? When the ovum is released from the ovary through the fallopian tubes, it enters into the uterus. When the ovulation occurs, means when the ovum is released out from the ovary, ovum is released. When the release of ovum from the follicles of the ovary, it is entered into the uterus through the fallopian tubes. When this ovum enters into the uterus, if there is a chance of entering of the sperm from the men through the vagina into the uterus, this ovum is going to mute with the sperm of which is entered into the uterus of the woman, then it forms a zygote. In this way, the ovum play a major role. If there is no chance of entering of the sperm into the uterus, then the ovum remains like that only. Means it is not going to fertilize in the uterus. If there is no fertilization, means the corpus luteum is going to convert into the corpus albicans. With the mature corpus luteum, if there is no fertilization occurred with the ovum, then the mature corpus luteum is converted into the corpus albicans, which is known as the white body. The corpus luteum is a yellow body, right? But the corpus albicans is the white body. This is the final step in the final change in the ovarian cycle. When the corpus albicans is formed, this corpus albicans is going to decrease the levels of the estrogen and progesterone in the ovary. Means the estrogen which is produced in the Graafian follicle stage and the progesterone which is produced in the mature corpus luteum stage, these are going to be decreased in the corpus albicans stage. When this estrogen and the progesterone are reduced or absent in the ovary, then in the menstrual cycle it is lead to the shedding of the endometrium cells. Why the shedding of the endometrium is occurred due to the decrease of the estrogen and the progesterone, means because this progesterone is going to make the endometrium edematous and secretory. It is going to provide the stiffness to the endometrium, and estrogen is going to make the regeneration of the endometrium. If there is no presence of this estrogen and the progesterone, there is no endometrium. That's why the endometrium is going to shed off the cells. The cells are going to shed off. From here, the uterine cycle is going to run. This is all about the ovarian cycle. The reverse form of the ovarian cycle is known as the uterine cycle. Today, said over here, just see in a flowchart form. Before this, the anterior pituitary gland is going to liberate the FSH and the LH. When the FSH is going to act on the immature for primary follicles in the ovary, it is going to convert into the mature primary follicle. This mature primary follicle is going to develop into the secondary follicle. This secondary follicle is got matured. When the secondary follicle is get matured, the graafian follicle is going to produce. This graafian follicle is going to produce the estrogen. When the estrogen is produced, then the luteinizing hormone in the ovary is going to be increased. When the luteinizing hormone is increased, the ovulation occurs. Means the follicle get ruptured and the ovum is released into the outside of the ovary. This all the development of the follicle is known as the follicular phase. I already said that ovarian runs with the two cycles, that is follicular and the luteal phase. The development of the follicles is known as the follicular phase. When the ovum releases, the corpus luteum is developed. The corpus luteum is converted into the mature corpus luteum. This mature corpus luteum is going to liberate the progesterone. It is going to make the endometrium edematous and secretory. When there is no fertilization occur, the mature corpus luteum is developed into the corpus albicans. This corpus albicans is going to decrease the levels of the estrogen as well as the progesterone, thereby leading to the shedding of the endometrium. The development of the luteums is known as the luteal phase. These are the two phases which occurred in the ovarian cycle, and this is the oral cycle of the ovary which occurred in the ovary. If due to this shedding of the endometrium or the development of the corpus albicans, it is going to produce the negative feedback to the hypothalamus, which is present in the brain. Through that negative feedback, the hypothalamus is going to run again to produce the cycle again and again. This is the major role played by the ovarian cycle in the ovary and the changes occurred in the ovary. I think you like this video and you may understand the video also. If you like the video, please do share, subscribe. And if you think that this video may help your friends, please do share also. And in the next video, I am going to give the detailed information about the changes occurred in the uterus, that is nothing but the uterine cycle. Thank you so much.